All right, welcome back from that short break. Now, in case you're just joining us, we are trying to address a situation, a love letter that is coming in from a lady who's writing to us saying that, hello, Aben, today. Guys, I love the show and how you give perspective to life. I wrote to you, but I haven't seen my issue being talked about, so I'll write to you again because it is getting serious. Don't mention my name. I've been dating my boyfriend for close to a year, and now 2 months ago, he asked me to move in with him. I stay at my parents' house, and I do not know how to do this. I asked him that he officially comes home for Kuchala, but he does not have the money now. But he promises it will be done, and no matter what happens, he does love me. He says it is better for us to move in and start our life together. The guy is good. I love him very much, but my parents on the other side will not let me leave the house, and they said it can only happen until marriage. I have a good job, and I'm not complaining. I've considered forcing my way out of home, but I fear what my father will do. Ever since my boyfriend brought it up, I got cold feet. I see him changing slowly. I can feel it. I love my family. I love my man, and I don't want to lose both of them. The studio lines are open. 0414337872 is the studio number to call. Feel free to give us a call and make sure that you remember to turn down the volume on your TV, and if possible, just turn it off. Willis, I want to talk about, you know, this line in this letter whereby the lady is talking about the fact that the man is changing slowly by slowly. I mean, this is
he's pulling away.
This is a couple that has been together for a year, so they literally know each other well. So what does, you know, this changing mean to this relationship?
It's human nature.
He's pulling away.
He's probably anticipated that by this time he should have moved in with someone and probably got married, but things haven't worked his way, so he's trying to find a way of hitting that goal. And you know, he's finding her disappointing because she's not agreeing to the terms, and neither is she giving him an option. You understand? She's just saying Kuchala or I'm not going. You understand? So there's no common ground, and you'd understand someone. It's
human nature.
It's human nature for him to, you know, try
pull
to
pull away
to pull away and let things go on. But you know, back to the you guys were saying 1 year is a short time to know someone. But you see, 1 year, when you say 1 year, you're saying one. I want you to say 365 days.
365
days. Very few days.
Still the very few days.
365 days. Talking to someone every single day. Good night. How are you? How was your morning? What is that? Of course, you can never know someone.
To the extent that you want to do Kuchala and you know the rest of the function.
Let me tell you, even if they gave you a lifetime, you can never master a human.
Of course.
That's true.
But 365 days.
Let me ask.
Even women, there's the 90-day rule. It's not 700 days or 2 years. It's 90 days. You understand? So for you to say you're going to spend 365 days to decide, and you say that's little time for you to decide, I think in this day and age where time is running, you know, the sun comes up at 7 and goes down at 8, I think you lose out on very many people. You need to have meaningful conversations whenever you start a serious relationship with someone. And by 2-3 months,
you
know where it's headed. You know if this guy is just for me, and you know, and this guy, you understand? So I think that 1 year is comfortable time for you as a woman to say, you know what?
Is he the one or not the one?
Is he the one? Is he? And women are sharper than men. They can tell through our lies. They can know our patterns. So 1 year is not really a short time for you to make a decision.
We're going to be picking out, of course, the callers coming through, and we shall be picking our first caller right about now. Hello?
Aben, today. Hello.
I think we lost that one, but try giving us a call right away back. 0414337872 is the studio line to call. Let's pick another caller. Hello.
Aben today. Hello.
Hello.
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm good.
What's your name and where are you calling from? The name is.
Volante.
Okay, what advice do you have for this fellow lady here?
No, like,
what do you have a child? Okay, I think we lost that one. The network was not quite clear, but let's pick another caller. 0414337872 is the studio line to call. We have someone on the line.
Hello.
All right, let's proceed.
I was going to say, but then again, as much as I've said what I've said to her about, because you can't have a stand. I also have a problem with, if you are an adult at this age, you are working, and you still have the fear of the Lord in your parents, first of all, kudos, it's good, it's respectable. But then for me, omukazi ngunu, muganda wange namuleta, simumuwa. Because she is so used to someone manning up in her life. She is so used to someone giving her rules. She is so used to having a hierarchy. That is why she is so scared to even take a leap of faith on herself. Do you get what I'm saying? Because if you're about 28, 27, you say you have a good job, you're not complaining, but you still stay in your father's house.
I mean, we can't be sure that she's 27 or 28.
Whatever age she is, the fact that she is of age and is working and is an adult, it shows you there's something lacking. It shows you on your mwana bamukuliziza kulish. Now, this is a girl you bring in.
Some parents prefer it that way, but I want you to hold into that thought. Let's pick another call and we get to find out what they have to say. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Yes, good morning.
Good morning. Morning to you.
How are you doing?
I'm very fine.
Yes, what's your name and where are you calling from?
I'm from Kansanga.
Kansanga, and what's your name?
I'm called Wise.
Yes, what advice do you have for this lady here?
Calling
your boss, and of course, thank you very much for watching Urban Television. Tino Mlalali Kusim. Yes, to it. Hello.
Urban Today, hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What's your name and where are you calling from, darling?
I'm from Moonbeam.
Sorry, I didn't get that. What's your name?
I'm Patricia.
Yes.
Patricia.
Patricia, what advice do you have?
The same problem.
Unfortunately, Patricia, we have to let you go because your network is not quite clear. We can't hear you. But give us another call, of course, absolutely right away. Do we have someone else on the line?
Hello.
All right. So, Tina, let's proceed with what you were saying.
No, what I'm saying is even he has to look at all these things. Yes, she's the one who wrote in and she's scared. Mm. But I bet you the reason why he's also pushing away, he's looking at it like, yo, I thought we have a relationship. And at some point, you had to leave your parents' house to have a real relationship.
Yeah, because but you don't just you leave your parents' house. You have to live it in the right way.
You can't just court, which for me shows... If this man had actually reached her parents' house, like the way they are dating, their parents would have put him on pressure, which means he has even never been anywhere close
to
the parents' house. Because if that's how they want their daughter taken, they would know there's someone seeing their daughter.
Okay.
So they are also oblivious to the situation. You may find if he actually were yes, it would have on a good day. I am looking for money. I have been dating your daughter and I want to come and make it right. You'll be shocked. The parents will be like, nice, very good. So what is needed? You get what I'm saying?
So basically there should be even a step before Kuchala, which should be the parents getting to know that there's someone in the daughter's lives.
Who actually wants to make a big leap? You see what I'm telling you? Because 1 year, 1 year with a girl that stays home, echitegeza, yebidida. Because at home she's supposed to be there at a certain time. We all know what it means to live in our parents' houses. There is a curfew even when you're an adult. So this is a woman. That's why I said it before. I'm like, this is a woman. Muganda wange simumuwa. She is used to someone. Ngayamuwa mateka.
We're going to pick about four callers and we get to find out. We hope the network has basically stabilized right about now. 0414-337-872 is the studio line. Hello?
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
I'm all right.
Fantastic. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Bandi.
What's your name and where are you calling from?
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
What's your name and where are you calling from?
Rian from Jinja, Azizi.
Oh,
Rian.
Wanji.
What's happening in Jinja, man?
We missed you.
Rian Chichi.
Rian in
what's up about the network? Why are you?
I think for me, her biggest problem is, you know, there's that color line between you as in your parents' house and you independently.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you something. There's nothing as uncomfortable as living in your parents' home. And there is never a right way to live.
Mm. Thank you.
Because
that's the nest you
Yeah, because
grew
you're
up
living
in
a relationship you've spent the whole of your life, and mm-hmm. you're now going to start your own life.
Mm-hmm.
Your parents, some parents get very jealous, and mm-hmm. they're overprotective, and say, you wait, kola ko tiri, ne wano te tukuwa mele, to sura, osasura renti, rato genda, tunawana funa musajja. But you need to stand your ground as an adult and say, you know what?
I'm moving out.
Kanginde. She can decide to say, you know what, let me just go and rent my own apartment and see how life is out there. I will come home and check on you as my
exactly.
parents and be there, but let me go and rent my own apartment. Mm. Then there you can make steps, you know, in
and
the future.
Decisions.
But as long as you're home now,
mm.
trust me, you're just waiting for your Shrek to come and give
but
you.
But also at the end of the day, I wouldn't advise you to move in with the man until this guy has done the first steps. At least the parents should know who you're seeing, and then
exactly.
maybe he does the kuchara. There's things of you moving in, and unless this man has made himself official.
You
don't want to be on the streets with two kids and the man has not even put a ring on it.
No,
the
thing is
day.
This. You're not moving in to have babies.
Mm.
No, you're moving
I mean,
to
when
coexist.
What are
yes.
the chances,
this thing is
what are the chances
yes.
that you're going to move in with someone? This is your boyfriend.
Mm.
You're going to be sleeping with him. You're going to be spending the entire evening with him.
Mm.
The weekend
that
you're not working with
him.
What are the chances that you'll actually not get pregnant?
It is called contraception.
The chances are there. I mean, they've been lodges.
They are
even
minimal.
Even when you're staying home, they are lodges.
They are minimal.
Where do you think they have
been?
I'm saying
they
are not there, but they are minimal.
Of course they are minimal.
So why do you want to get into a situation then jump out of it? Why don't you prevent it from happening?
I do not want to disrespect religious institutions or cultural institutions, but we are overrating the thing
the whole marriage
kwanjula kuchala and wedding. We overrate them. Let me tell you, there is no formula.
I don't think it's overrated.
There is no formula in life
to a successful marriage.
There is nothing like, let no one lie to you, Derek, that in order for you to have a successful marriage,
that's true.
It has to be in this direction.
I agree with you.
That for a man to be able to respect you and have a long-lasting relationship with him,
you're supposed
to
be like
this.
That's very true, Willis. I agree with you. But why do you want to stay with someone's daughter if their parents do not even know you at all?
No.
No, that is
why are you doing that?
No, that is her fault, not mine.
What
do you mean it's her fault?
It's her fault, not mine.
You as someone who actually wants to be serious with this woman, you're
supposed
to tell her, I actually want to meet your parents.
No. Naya Simu Siru, she's supposed to understand that this relationship...
Come on.
This relationship is like this, and she's supposed to go tell her parents, like, Mom, Dad,
yes.
I'm seeing this guy. I really think I like him, and he would really want
Omani,
to swear.
Omani rati wagamba, omuchara ya yanjula, omusaja ya yanjula.
Yes.
I think what she should do is get the guy, introduce the guy to your brothers,
or a sister.
Be known, a sister. Let
an
the conversation begin slowly.
Mm-hmm.
But do not say before you until they bring
come
10 cows and 10 goats, you're not leaving your father's
Who
house.
Are you?
In this economy, you will die single.
It is what? Better to die in your own bedroom than your man's bedroom. Abend Today still continues. We're going for a very short break. Of course, we'll be getting into some feedback on our social media pages regarding this love letter. Nicholas is joining us for the latest of what is happening in the world of sports.